Atlantic City, are y'all ready for your main event? Fuck yeah, let's get it.
Ellie Catch making her way to the ring with Effie at her side. All business. Steel cage versus Charles Mason. Of course, the cage designed to make sure it stays one-on-one between these two, but of course they have their associates as well.
Well, I mean, at this point, there's no way that Ellie could come out here without some sort of backup, even if it's just Effie on the outside of the cage. Because we have seen time and again that Charles Mason always has minions lurking everywhere.
They faced one another at our last event in Los Angeles. It was supposed to be everyone banned from ringside, be it Effie or Dark Sheik in the corner of Alley Catch, or Mason and his mercenaries, such as Perro or Slade. But it all broke down once the referee was out of commission, and everyone did wind up getting involved in the fray, led to Ellie Catch challenging Mason to this steel cage showdown, your main event here at GCW Ransom. The showboat solidly behind Ellie Catch as she awaits the entrance of Charles Mason, who has been a thorn in her side 4 months now.
This is not the first time that we have seen Charles Mason in a steel cage here at the Showboat. Look at Allie. She's kind of like just jittery looking around.
Mason with Perro backing him up.
Now, as you mentioned, okay, well, don't do that.
Everybody better stay out of their way.
Mason has his eyes locked on that cage and locked on Alley Catch as he came through the curtain. It's only now he's taking some time to just jaw off with the fans, but... Oh, everything he does is just so... creepy.
Yeah, look at the way he's touching the cage that he's gonna put to use as a weapon. And he'll also have Ellie trapped inside of it, which I'm sure he's just gonna love. He enjoys it. He's licking his fingers. Ugh.
Mason really taking his time getting into this cage, whereas Allie, she came right down and stepped inside. She is ready to get this started.
Both competitors now inside the steel.
This is your main event for GCW Ransom. It is a cage match. You can win via pinfall, submission, or escaping the cage, either over the top or through the door with both feet hitting the floor. our outside officials, Mr. Dan Perch and Miss Scarlett Donovan. On the inside of the ring, our senior GCW official, Mr. Adam Gault. Introducing first, to my right, fighting out of the great state of Texas, as a member of Bussy, she is a former GCW World Tag Team Champion. This is Allie Cash. And her opponent to my left. He is accompanied to ringside this evening by Paro. He is the root of all evil. This is Charles Mason.
Cage door being shut and chain shut around the ring post. As MLJ already announced, pinfall, submission, or escape. The ways to win this matchup.
Oh!
And immediately Allie spinning right into the face of Charles Mason and going after him.
Allie is Mason trapped in a corner, taking him around the ring.
The steel cage keeping the others out, keeping these two locked in with one another. An opportunity for Allie Cash to truly deliver some payback.
Allie now again dragging Mason. Oh.
Going for the pile driver here in the early going. But Mason works his way out of that position.
Whoa. Allie got caught but able to escape.
Hit that knee strike on Mason. Tries to hit the ropes, but Allie with the DDT! Drove Mason head first into the mat.
Mason struggling to pull himself up by the ropes at all. Here comes Allie. Oh.
Mason moves out of the corner. Runs into the elbow from Allie. He climbs up to the second rope. Has Mason stunned. And takes him off his feet once again.
This has really been all Allie Cash.
And Perro unable to come to the aid, to lend a helping hand to Charles Mason as he has done in the past. Flurry of punches in the corner now from Allie Cash.
Oh, but Mason from underneath. Oh!
And she's trapped between the cage and the top rope. Like a running powerbomb into the steel.
And although this was all Allie Cash in control for a while, I think that Charles Mason has just totally turned this match around.
Mason grabbing hold of Allie. Looking to drive her head first into the cage. The unforgiving steel.
Now, as you mentioned, Dave, this match can be won by pinfall, submission, or escape. And Charles Mason doesn't seem interested in any of those options right now.
Now he's just brutalizing Allie like he loves to do and has done on so many occasions in the past.
Oh. Is he looking to escape?
He has the opportunity.
No.
But choosing not to. Like I said, he gets some kind of sick enjoyment out of dishing out a beating to Allie, to Effie. Dark Sheik just messing with all of them and manipulating Billy Dixon as well, taking advantage of his family situation, paying for his mother's hospital bills, forcing Billy Dixon to do things that he otherwise would not have.
Oh, Ali already bleeding.
That steel cage coming into play, tearing at the flesh of Ali Catch, and now like a cheese grater, just raking her flesh across the mesh cage. Oh, just disgusting.
Ali crawling over to the ropes.
Just trying to cause that cut to be opened up even further. And more blood to flow to cloud the vision of Ali Catch.
Oh, Mason with a handful of hair.
Chopping away at the chest.
Oh, Ali able to reverse. Big back body drop.
Spun Mason in the midst of that body drop. And despite the blood loss, Ali was back on her feet right there, but taken off her feet by Mason.
Yeah, I thought that was going to be a little bit of recovery time for Ali Catch, but no, sent back into the cage.
Mason elevates Ali, belly to back suplex.
Mason now crawling across the ring. Does go for a pinfall.
Only two though. Gonna take a lot to keep Ali down for a three count in this matchup. But you can tell this blood loss is starting to affect her.
Oh. Mason just wrenching back the jaw. Ah!
Just pulling away on the jaw, tearing away at the face of Ali Catch.
Mason already covered in blood. Oh!
The showboat encouraging Ali to fire back here.
Another big chop.
Gets the elbow up into Mason. The boot this time. Ali Catch.
Whoa.
Over a head scissors here, but Mason swings her into the steel cage. Back and forth.
Every time it seems like Ali Catch might be able to turn this around, Mason is just one step ahead.
Again, just pulling her up by the face, grabbing her nose, grabbing her mouth, and now driven head first into the top turnbuckle, stained with the blood of Ali Catch now. And just looking to choke her out, elevating Ali, trying to cut off the circulation.
Mason breaks the hold, but Allie's still down.
Referee making sure that she's able to continue in this match. If she needs to give it up, he will call for the bell.
Oh, again, back to the jaw.
And Allie with the chin breaker, frees herself. Back on her feet.
Mason, all the way in the other corner. Oh, baited Ali in.
And now double knees in the corner from Mason. And that rolling Death Valley driver. And creepily crawling to go for a cover, perhaps. Maybe even not. But sitting up and getting right in his face.
Ali Catch still fighting.
Has her by the throat, but Ali with shots to the midsection. forearm shot now, once again. And Mason biting her now.
Wait.
Puts on the brakes in the corner.
Oh, but a dropkick sends Allie back into the ropes. Oh!
Drives Mason head first into the canvas.
He was going for another one of those Death Valley drivers. Somehow Allie catch, able to turn it into almost like a destroyer.
An excellent counter by Allie Catch has Mason down, giving Allie a little bit of time to regain her bearings if she can, continuing to lose a lot of blood.
Allie pulling herself up by the ropes. Mason doing the same. Mason gets in first, but Allie had that spotted.
And crashing down across the chest of Mason. And now, hip attack in the corner. Signature Allie Catch here. Firing herself up for the cannonball.
Connecting, but Allie Catch. Oh, Mason from behind.
But Allie, Northern Lights suplex for the bridge. Ooh, very close. Almost had him down for three.
Mason kicks out right before the three count.
Allie pulls herself back up. Going for the pile driver once again. Can she get it?
Whoa.
Mason spits right in her face. Disgusting. She's been through so much as a result of this lunatic just messing with her life, trying to make things difficult.
Allie sending Charles Mason into all the walls of the cage. It looks like Allie, I think, would have had the opportunity to escape there, but now she is choosing to stay in the ring.
I mean, both of them, Mason for his own sick reasons, but Allie just to get some payback, want their opponent inside that ring to dish out that punishment, to use the cage as a weapon. And Mason covered in blood as well.
Oh, Mason fights his way out back to that choke.
Allie frees herself. Scoops up Mason, Michinoku driver, cover. Ooh, so close, but Mason gets the shoulder up. It's a good shot of the blood pouring out of the head of Charles Mason as a result of the attack from Allie Catch inside this steel cage.
Allie grabs Mason by the back of the shirt. She's dragging him in, loading him up on the top turnbuckle.
Exposing the chest for the overhand chop.
Allie maybe looking for a superplex here.
Has him hooked for it, but Mason trying to gain the advantage.
Mason slides underneath.
Maybe looking for a powerbomb out of the corner here, but Allie holding onto the top of the cage to block it. And several shots to the head of Mason.
Mason is staggered. Oh, but caught the foot. Oh, and biting again.
Doing whatever he can to maintain an advantage.
Oh.
Another rolling Death Valley driver. Allie with the shoulder up again.
Mason got all of that DVD, and somehow Allie Catch still kicking out. Mason himself looks barely able to stand. And Pero.
Looks like he just sent some handcuffs inside the ring to Mason. We saw that used as a weapon in Los Angeles. Two pairs of handcuffs. I mean, even from the floor, Pero getting involved. Low blow from Ali. It's all legal in this thing.
Now Ali has hold of those handcuffs. I think Pero, look at you, Pero pacing on the outside. I don't know if there's anything he can do.
Yeah, this wasn't what he had in mind. But it's Ali trying to handcuff Charles Mason to the steel cage now.
Mason is fighting it, and look, Pero's right there too to stop it.
Yeah, Mason will be defenseless if he is cuffed to this cage. She's got one hand cuffed to the cage. Looks like she's gonna go for the second.
Again, Pero is right there. He is inches away.
But he's on the outside of the cage. Nothing he can do about it. And Ali has Charles Mason right where she wants him. And going into her knee pad, she's got the knife.
And Mason handcuffed to the cage.
We've seen Ali catch in the past when driven to this point. Utilize that knife.
Oh!
Kicks the knife out of her hand, though, and kicking away on the face of Ali Catch. Mason trying to defend himself here.
Yeah, I don't know what Mason was going to be able to do. Oh, wait, Pero!
He's got a pair of cutters cutting those cuffs to free Charles Mason from the cage. Mason has been freed from the cage. He's trying to get the door open. We have the door of the cage chained shut. It's only supposed to be open when someone's about to escape. And Pero, he's trying to climb the cage.
Oh, but wait, here comes Effie with the chair.
Coming to the aid of Ali, making sure that Pero does not get involved from the floor. And he's got his pearls wrapped around his neck. Using those pearls as a weapon. On Pero. Effie and Pero going at it on the floor here. Still a score to be settled between those two. They're taking their fight toward the locker room.
And Mason, I don't think he expected Pero to leave ringside.
It's one on one, and now pile driver.
Whoa.
Mason able to kick out at 2 3/4. Ali thought she had him. Well, Effie and Pero have brawled to the locker room, keeping this between Ali and Charles Mason.
Mason is out. I think Ali just realized, she's looking around, she's looking high, maybe she realizes.
This could be her chance to escape.
Yeah.
Ali starting to climb the cage. Again, she can go over the top or through the door. Both feet must touch the floor to win by escape.
Ali's almost at the top, but Mason.
He's back on his feet, trying to put a stop to it. Mason climbing up. They're both standing on the middle of that top rope.
Oh.
Both wrestlers in a position where if they can get over the top of that cage, they can potentially escape and win. Just fighting for the advantage, exchanging shots.
Ali nailing these punches. Oh, but Mason again biting.
Biting the head.
Oh.
And driving Ali repeatedly head first into the cage. and down she crashes back into the middle of the ring.
This is Mason's opportunity. If he can make it over the top and to the floor.
Is he even going to try? No! Elbow off the top rope by Mason. He had the chance to escape, but instead, elbow and now a cover. Allie gets the shoulder up.
Charles Mason might be regretting his choices right now. Watch this elbow drop. He nailed it, but Allie Cat still kicked out. I think Mason could have escaped over the top.
He's trying to choke her out once again, but Allie fighting it off. Drives Mason into the corner to free herself. Elbows to the midsection.
Allie crawling, trying to get away. Mason right back on that choke.
More elbows. Free herself from his grasp. Allie charges across the ring, but Mason sidesteps her and headfirst into the steel once again.
Looks like Mason getting ready to climb again. He wants out.
We'll try to win this matchup. Allie sees that he's trying to escape, and she's back on her feet.
Charles Mason's got one leg over the top, and Allie Catch hold of that ankle.
Doing whatever she can to block his attempt at escaping the cage. He's over the top now. Both feet must touch the floor.
Oh.
Allie with a huge superplex off the top of the cage, sending Mason crashing back down inside the ring.
Once again, though, if Allie can't capitalize on this.
And there's Billy Dixon at ringside.
Is that the key?
We've seen Billy Dixon trying to help and support Effie, but at the same time, Mason still trying to manipulate him, knowing that his family needs Mason's money to pay Billy Dixon's mother's hospital bills. But he's trying to help open that door so that Allie can escape. She's crawling. Just has to crawl through that door. Both feet touch the floor, and Allie's got this victory here. Allie crawling to escape the cage.
Mason's still pretty, he's yelling at Billy Dixon. Billy closes the cage.
Mason again intimidating Billy Dixon into doing his bidding.
Oh.
Slap across the face of Allie. Continuing to talk trash, to play those mind games. But they're face to face.
Mason finally taking off that blood-soaked shirt. Oh.
Allie back on her feet, kicking away.
Oh, Mason though fires right back. Allie staggering towards the corner.
Atlantic City again encouraging Allie Catch as she fires away with punches and forearm shots on Mason.
Again, Allie just beating Charles Mason into the canvas. Oh, but Mason with a chop to the throat. Whoa.
Allie though, it's a roll up here. Only two, both wrestlers to their feet. Catches the kick attempt, knee strike from Allie.
Mason went through the ropes.
And now draping him across the second rope. It's that pile driver from that position at sometimes.
Yeah, and Mason was able to fight it.
And dumps Allie right on her head.
Oh.
Allie with the shoulder up.
Mason, though, immediately transitioning back into this choke.
Trying to make Allie pass out here. She's trying to hang on. Look at the eyes of Mason rolling into the back of his head. He loves this.
Official's going to need to check on this.
Referee checking on Allie's condition. She looks to be out. The arm falls once, twice, one more, and this thing's over with.
Oh,
no!
No!
Allie still has some fight left in her.
You can hear the carousel room come alive for Allie Cash. She's back on her feet.
Mason trying to keep the hold cinched in. Allie using the turnbuckles for some leverage.
Whoa.
Oh, very close to a three count right there. Tilt a whirl into the tombstone pile driver from Mason.
Wait.
He pulled her up.
Yeah, Allie didn't kick out of that tombstone.
He could have won the match right there, but instead pulling her up because he gets off on dishing out this punishment.
Oh, he has the knife.
Allie brought it into the cage. And now Mason.
Oh.
Pulling Allie up. Charles Mason attempting to use the knife, but Allie with a sleeper hold of her own.
Allie is cinched on tight. Mason is going down.
Trying to cut off the circulation, choke him out. Will Mason, will he pass out here?
Official is checking. That's it.
The winner of the match, Allie Cash.
Allie Cash scores the win inside the steel cage.
The entire canvas covered in blood. Now I have to ask, and hope, is this finally the end of this reign of terror from Charles Mason? Has Allie Cash finally done it?
Time will tell whether that is true, Veda Scott. But on this night, Allie Cash is victorious, getting a measure of revenge on Charles Mason in your main event here at GCW Ransom. We've seen history made, new tag team champions tonight, and Allie Cash victorious here at your main event. Folks, be sure to join us next weekend for IWS versus GCW live from Montreal.